So here we go again, another plane. And that's the thing, I really, really, really don't like planes.
This is a man which is going to take me into the depths of the unknown.
How are you?
You ready to go on screen?
Yeah. Let's start.
Si te pierdes en la selva, nunca volverás, okay?
Yeah, see. Water, big trees, many birds, all good.
I will say this, anyone that comes to the jungle wanting to conquer this landscape, you will be turned around very fast.
I've hit something, and it's not gold. They're perfectly designed to do one thing. A, obviously being water.
Oh!
Let the water settle. Stay calm, relaxed. I'll find it. My fingers are working, it's all good.
Wow! Look at him in defense posture.
Now from that angle there,
it looks like a very big snake.
He's known as the Bushmaster. And I tell you what, you just see the size of him.
They're gonna be going for anything that comes their way, anything which is silly enough to go past this branch, they're gonna grab it.
Being in a tree with a porcupine, two things. A, I don't like heights, and B, I don't like spikes.
Ooh. The bitey little one.
Oh. Ah, gotcha!
Tell you a funny story because...
Fox coral snake and true coral snake have the same patterning, almost identical. Red, white, black. But this guy here is highly neurotoxic.
Now the hardest part is actually getting inside the coconut. There's not much out here on the floodplain that you can use to actually crack open a coconut. But there is one thing.
Quite a dangerous animal. Essentially, water is his element.
Yeah, you do your thing. I'm gonna do mine.
When you see a dead animal like this, you probably think, oh well, there's probably nothing you can do about it, right? But when I see a dead animal, I see opportunities.
And essentially, that's exactly how you set your golden trap.
I'm gonna get this guy under control.
Okay. Ah! Bloody bit me!
I got him by the tail, but...
A lot of power to him. A lot of power. And essentially, they are a digger.
I can't always be serious down here!
Now it's amazing because he understands the advantages of his camouflage and obviously that's why he's not moving.
Whoa!
Oh, fucking terrible. Absolutely massive. Still alive. And so is he.
Ah! Oh! Alright. So this guy here, he's known as the Tam Injure. Quite a display. And you can just see that he's a very calculated animal.
See this face? See it? This is what stress looks like.
This here. This here. Now this here is an agouti! Guys,
this guy here has to be clever because he has to avoid athletes of the jungle, the cats.
You can just see this is trying to get a hold of. You just see how beautiful he is. Wow. Look at you. Hey, mate. Just want to give him a hug.
Ah! Until they latch on like that. Ah, shit! Shit! Ah! Oh, shit! Shit!
Oh. Oh, that was just like, look, it was like blades going in. Big fat one, which he wasn't too fast in the mark, but kept ahead of me.
Settle with me. The funny thing about the capybara is this guy here, he's the largest rodent in the world. You're probably thinking, how is this a rodent? Well, church, amazingly it is.